Obviously, we didn't have enough time to talk on air about the millions of things that are going to happen during this session, but Senator Beffort, you're going to be talking about funding for early childhood education. Tell us what you're doing.
Well, I'm very excited. For the second year in a row, we have a major increase in funding for early childhood programs, about $35 million in this budget. And what we are doing is working on programs that have been research-based and accountable, things like the extended education for kindergarten for at-risk children, things such as early childhood learning and the pre-K programs and that sort of thing. And so I see this as the absolute only prospect of getting our children, our at-risk children that may not have all the advantages of some of our other children to be ready for kindergarten and be on par in first grade and start that reading like we're hoping.
You are not behind the proposal that would take money from the permanent fund for this, is that right?
Or I am not. We have seen the erosion in the severance tax permanent fund, which is basically finished. The only thing we have is the corpus to work on. And so what these funds are doing is spinning off out of their corpus major amounts of money, over $600 million. For education that we do not have to tax our own citizens for.
And we have a little bit more money this year. We're feeling a little bit more flush, so you feel like you can find that money elsewhere. You don't have to tap into the permanent fund.
I think that $35 million is a major amount of money to start adding to research-based accountable programs.
Senator Keller, should we take it out of the permanent fund?
We need big change ideas to help a system, an education system that has been hurting for a long time. And $35 million is important, it's helpful, but we need another zero after that. And the only way we can do it is that bill. So I think if we want to see change in the next 3 or 4 years, we've got to do something a lot bigger.
We want to see more loose change, perhaps. And you've been looking at unspent money around the state. Where are we dropping coins?
Well, the unfortunate situation, I think, is our state, while we're having challenges economically and with education and healthcare, our state is doing great. We've come out of this recession fiscally with excess cash stored away all over. So, for example, there's $100 million in a water infrastructure fund in the economic in the Environment Department right now. We're calling for water infrastructure funding. It's already there. We just need to spend it.
The Children, Youth, and Families Department got an allowance and didn't spend all of it?
Reversions. So we've had $64 million in reversions. That includes, of course, this real tragedy where the caseload is so high that we're not returning phone calls fast enough that I think contributed to the situation with OMRE. And that was solely because of not spending money that had already been allocated. So on top of that, there's excess bonding capacity all over our sort of finance entities, so the finance authority. We could be rebuilding New Mexico right now. We actually have the money. Right now, we just don't have sort of the political will or the bureaucratic ability to make it happen.
Senator Beffort, I know there's a couple things in there you disagree with, but let me get you to talk a little bit about behavioral health and how you want to spend money on that.
Sure. Well, behavioral health is a little bit of a separate question, but we have got to get to the bottom of what happened with this botched behavioral health audit. And you're going to see in the session, I think, hearings that we're going to hold on behavioral health. And I have some legislation as well as others to clean up the loopholes that were used for no-bid contracts for Arizona companies. And this is just transparency and accountability in our healthcare system, which right now we don't have because everything is new as of 10 or 20 years ago. So constitutionally, we're wholly inadequate to be dealing with these issues right now.
Now, before we let you go, I want to get your opinion, Senator Beffort, on some of the education things we talked about. The lottery scholarship. What do you think we should do to fix it?
Well, of course, the lottery scholarship is something that we are very proud of and one of the only states in the whole United States that offers a free education to anyone that graduates. So there are some push-pull issues, some that say that you should have at least 15 hours as opposed to 12. Obviously, when a student has to take another year or even 2 years, that's another expenditure for the lottery.
That you're saying that when students come to UNM, they're spending a lot of their lottery scholarship money on remedial courses just to get them to be where they're supposed to be when they start?
Or not taking a full load. For instance, we have spent a lot of money on improving the remedial piece of what students have, but we have grade point issues that we might be considering, and then there are other prospects of at-risk that that some legislators are looking at?
If we raise the GPA requirement, then we're getting a pool of people, many of whom maybe would already have gone and don't need the money, right? Is that one of the things you're worried about? If we, if we narrow the pool of people who get the scholarship just by GPA instead of by, say, need, you're going to be looking at those two.
Well, of course, the lottery goes to two-year schools as well, so we're serving, two different populations. But what we are trying to do and what we have done in earlier budgets is we are trying to, for instance, the STEM courses that Senator Keller mentioned, we're trying to gear higher payments towards courses that will have jobs as opposed to just going through school and getting out and no jobs are available. So we have
Liberal arts majors
on medical and areas that are very important to our economy. So the lottery has to be fixed. We have lots of money available that we're going to put in this year because of our excess new money, but we have to have a long-term fix.
And I know the students who work here in our studio are listening with great interest to this topic. Thank you both for staying extra time to talk to us.
Thank you.
Thank you.